Welcome to the weekly update by SofLogic Stockbrokers. The All-Share Price Index increased by 538.9 points to close at 11,197.7, while the S&P/SL Index gained by 148 points to close at 3,822.6. The ASPI reached an all-time high during the week with a healthy turnover of 39.5 billion. Net foreign sales recorded at Rs. 1.5 billion where local investor interest was seen in capital goods, diversified financials, transportation and food and beverage sectors. On the macroeconomic front, the Monetary Board of the Central Bank of Sri Lanka decided to keep policy rates unchanged. Further, the Central Bank Governor Ajit Nivad Kabral stated that they intend to boost the island's foreign exchange reserves, which had fallen approximately to $3.5 billion by the year end. Furthermore, the government lifted the ban on the importation and use of chemical fertilizer. The government ensures support by way of subsidies, maximum price guarantees. However, will be limited to those who use non-hazardous inputs. These are the crossings for the week. On the travel and tourism industry, Sri Lanka surpassed a record high in tourist arrivals in the month of October for the year. With the rollout of the third booster, we are likely to see a further improvement in the tourism sector. On top of that, the PIA expansion project is underway. The Japan-funded PIA expansion is the largest development project undertaken by the government. With an increase in aircraft parking slots, increase in passenger handling capacity and check-in counters are likely to see positive implications. The full expansion project is expected to be fulfilled in the year 2023. On the company highlights, the successful IPO Sabadaya Development Finance took place with Rs. 1 billion accumulated within the launch. The ECT construction deal to China Harbour was granted through Access Engineering. LOLC retains the top spot in the LMD 100 as the most profitably listed entity for the year. An 80 million deal was undertaken between John Keel's Holding and ADB Bank. Further, the IPO for the week to look forward to is the Senate, which offers 55 million shares at a price of Rs. 12.5.
Moving on to the technicals, after 2 weeks of indecision, the buyers were able to take the upper hand with the All Share Price Index closing up roughly 5% on the week and the SL20 closing up roughly 4% on the week. With price action shifting strongly back to the buying side, we believe our price target of 11,600 is achievable over the coming weeks. However, we stand by what we said last week on putting more emphasis on the SL20 index. With prices yet to reach its all-time highs, more potential can be seen on the SL20 relative to the All-Share Price Index. That being said, price action remains bullish on all three timeframes, the short term, the medium term and the long term time frames remain favorable to the buyers on both indices.
Thank you for tuning in today.